congratulations to today's daily shoutout winners. If you want to win a shoutout, leave a nice comment down below for a chance to win a shoutout in my next video.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, hi, my name is Lissy. Be sure to subscribe button if you guys have not, because we are getting so close to 2 million subscribers. Also guys, be sure to drop a like on today's video if you guys also love water slides. I really love water slides. I've always loved them since I was a little kid. I used to always go to this place called Wisconsin Dells. I don't know if you guys have heard of it, but all my Wisconsin people, I'm sure you guys have. I used to go there all the time when I was little, and they had some of the craziest water slides that I have ever seen. I also always used to go to a Holiday Inn that I lived by growing up that had kind of like a tiny water park in it, and that's when I learned to love water slides growing up. Until you're that awkward kid on a floaty who gets off a water slide and then submerges himself underwater, and then somebody floats on top of you with a really big tube, and then you can't swim around them. That is terrifying. But today, we're going to be talking about some of the most scary, deadliest, creepiest, and craziest water slides that were ever built in the entire world. And trust me, when I say there's some crazy water slides out there, I really do mean it, because some of the water slides we're going to be talking about today are insane. The tea is hot, and without further ado, let's get started. Coming in at number one, we have the Leap of Faith in the Bahamas. So this is actually 60 feet up in the air, and thrill seekers will get to jet down an open air water slide and through a tube that's actually surrounded by an entire shark tank. So when I say that you literally are sliding through a shark tank in a water slide, I do be meaning it. I don't know who would want to do that to themselves. I don't know about you guys, but I have always had the fear of thinking, like, what if an aquarium tank actually broke when you were walking through an aquarium and all the sharks came out and attacked you? Well, that's exactly the same exact fear I think about when looking at this water slide, because you're literally sliding through an actual tank of sharks and they're swimming around you while you're in the slide. And even crazier than that, there hasn't been any deaths of humans that I found online about the slide. However, there's been a death or suicide of a shark. A shark jumped into the slide on the Leap of Faith and died due to complications from the chlorine. This shark was a 12-year-old female rig shark, and it jumped over an 18-inch wide and 1-foot high sustaining structure into the resort's Leap of Faith water slide. So it's kind of sad that the shark died, of course, but I mean, it's a little more concerning that a shark could jump over the structure they had and onto the water slide. At least the park was closed when this happened, because if the park was open when the shark jumped over into the water slide when a guest was on it, that would have not ended well. And that would have been the most terrifying experience in the world. But yeah, sharks can't handle chlorine, so the shark sadly passed away. Next scary water slide. So the next scary water slide we're going to be talking about is the Insano water slide built in Brazil. The Insano water slide stands tall at 134 feet high. It has a vertical drop into an exit below. This water slide was opened in 1989 and was the tallest water slide ever built in the entire world at the time that it was first built. Some of the water slide workers claim that when people go on this water slide, that once they get to the top, they regret it and they start having a panic attack or crying. Some workers say that people seem excited to get onto it, and then when they see them sliding down through the slide, they actually see people crying and panicking while on the slide. If that doesn't show you guys how tall and scary the slide is, I don't know what does. The slide is only a total of 5 seconds long, but because this ride is so steep that when some people go on it, their butt actually releases off the ground and they're airborne in the air on the slide for a matter of time, and then they hit back down onto the slide, which I find to be terrifying. I would not want to, like, literally gravitationally pull up off of a water slide and then slam back down onto it because it's so steep. That is dangerous. And because that's so dangerous, when you're on this water slide, you actually have to have your arms crossed and your feet crossed the entire time, or you can get extremely seriously injured. Sadly, this slide is no longer the tallest water slide in the world. However, it does remain to be one of the fastest slides in the world at the current moment still. The sliders can actually reach speeds of up to 65 miles per hour while on this water slide. Also, the slide gives a really incredible view of the Atlantic Ocean at the very top. But needless to say, this is not a water slide that you'd want to get injured on, because if you were to fall from the top of this slide, you would die. There's no going back. If you don't follow the rules and keep your arms crossed and your legs crossed, you are going to get seriously injured. So the next slide we're going to be talking about is Aqua Loop water slide at Wet n Wild in Australia. This water park is actually the busiest water park in all of Australia. In fact, I think it's the 8th most busiest water park in the entire world. During this water slide, there's a near vertical tube that sends the riders down a steep drop where riders can reach extremely fast speeds, in fact, fast enough speeds to reach the loop in this slide. Yeah, you heard me. There's a literal loop in this water slide somehow. That's that actually scares me a lot. I know I've been on loops and like roller coasters, but I can't imagine a water slide. The man was actually severely injured on this slide in 1994. However, though, all sliders are supposed to reach a fast enough speed to make it into the loop. Sadly, not all sliders do reach that speed. A woman that didn't make it into the loop got stuck in the slide and sued the water park for $400,000. She found herself stuck on the ride and tried to pull herself out through an escape hatch and had several really bad injuries. So that would be a slide that nobody would want to get stuck on, or a loop that you wouldn't want to miss. That's pretty scary. Next water slide. The next water slide we're going to be talking about is called the Aqua Loop. This one is actually at the Adventure Pool Complex in Slovenia. Aqua Loop is one of the fastest water slides in the entire world. The Slovenian water slide also features an accelerating 360-degree loop that will undoubtedly confuse your senses as you race to the bottom of the slide. There are now actually 20 Aqua Loop installations all around the world. The first one that was ever installed was the Slovenia one, though. During this slide, you reach extreme fast speeds because you have to go fast enough, just like the last one, to actually reach those loops. And it's launched off a 56-foot platform. A single rider is loaded onto the launch chamber where it accelerates with a fast speed in just 2 seconds before entering the loop element. The element is a variation of the traditional vertical loop because it lies on an angle of approximately 45 degrees. This variation of a loop is called the inclined loop. However, there has been some bad injuries on this slide, unfortunately, as well. A teenage girl ended up suffering a terrible spinal injury while riding the Aqua Loop water slide at the Wet n Wild on the Gold Coast. She was hospitalized with a possible spinal injury, which is pretty unfortunate because we all know that some of these water slides eventually could break or have a defect that could happen, which is always a dangerous risk. So the taller and the more scarier the slide, the more higher of a risk. Next water slide. So this last water slide we're going to be talking about was the tallest water slide ever made in the entire world. It's called the Vuruk water slide, and it was in amusement park in Kansas City, but unfortunately this water slide was so tall and so dangerous and so deadly that it got shut down. Sadly, a man died on this water slide on August 7th. This water slide stood tall at 168 feet. It also was a two-person raft ride somehow, and it went up to 50 miles per hour. When a young man was riding it, he was riding a raft with two women who also suffered minor injuries when the incident occurred, but sadly when he was riding this ride, he ended up getting so severely injured that he died on this water slide. We all know that 168 feet is already really tall, especially even for just a roller coaster, so imagine being that high up in the air on a water slide. Obviously, that was not a good idea, and this water slide was extremely deadly and extremely dangerous, so they ended up completely pulling it and taking it off, because that was not a safe situation at all, and sadly somebody lost their life. So I don't even think you'd catch me riding some of these water slides. Anyways, guys, comment down below, have you guys ever been to a water park, and if so, what's your favorite water park? My favorite water park probably would have to be the Wilderness in Wisconsin Dells. That one stands out to me a lot from my childhood because they had some really cool water slides. Anyways, guys, thank you all so much for watching today's video. If you guys enjoyed it, be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button so you guys don't miss out on future videos. It's been Lissy. I love you guys all so much. God bless you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys!
So that was it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to hit the subscribe button, be sure to drop a like, and be sure to leave a comment down below. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.